Hello and welcome back to my channel. I am Desilis Couture and today I'm going to show you how I cut out stabilizers out of my seam allowances. Okay, so now I have a pattern piece right here for the flap of a wallet, but then I need, you know, a stabilizer for this pattern piece. I've cut out the fabric already, but I need a stabilizer for this flap. In this case, I have the deco bound here, but I need also a pattern piece in order to, you know, cut out some of, because this stabilizer is exactly the shape of the of this fabric of the pattern and of this fabric of the flap. But then I need this stabilizer to be smaller, so that I will be able to take out some bulk out of my seam allowances. If I sew it like this, it'll be too much for my machine to take. Even though I have an industrial machine, it will still be too much, you know, to take for my machine, and also to turn. Also, it'll be a little bit of a hassle to turn this piece out. So I need to take some of the stabilizer out of my seam allowance. In this case, the seam allowance for this pattern piece is 3/8 of an inch. So I would like to take 3/8 of an inch out of this pattern piece all around. So what I do is I use my seam allowance ruler. This is a very handy tool for me. I created it myself with the help of my son, who designed it, the shape and everything, and it helps me to trace my seam allowances perfectly and consistently on all my pattern pieces. So it has the zipper template in the middle here, 3/8 of an inch by 7.5. here is a ruler, but it's really whatever length you choose for your pattern piece, for your zipper. Sorry, but then it also comes with three sizes of seam allowances. In this case, we have 3/8 of an inch that's marked here, we have 4/4 of an inch as for this side, and 1/2 an inch, which is for this side of the roller. So since I have to take 3/8 of an inch out of this pattern piece all around, what I'll do is I will place my ruler like so. I place my ruler at the corner of my ruler at the edge of my fabric, of my fabric piece, and I use my marking pen to place it like this. That's where I'm going to cut out, or this is the part 3/8 of an inch that I'm going to cut out of this pattern piece. I come down here still. I make sure that I follow, since this is a straight line already, I make sure that the edge of my ruler is at the edge of my fabric, and I follow this straight line and I trace again. On this side, 3/8 of an inch. I make sure that I mark 3/8 of an inch right here. And I come here, I mark 3/8 of an inch again, making sure that it lines up with that one, and I trace again, and then I trace the entire line. This side, I do the same. I mark 3/8 of an inch right here. I come here on this side, I make sure that I have 3/8 of an inch here, and I line up here perfectly. In this way, I don't calculate anything. I don't put I don't use those small lines on those classic rulers, because my eyes are not what it used to be anymore. So on this curve, I still need 3/8 of an inch. So this is the 3/8 of an inch side of my ruler. So for every 3/8, I'll come and mark right here. 3/8, I'll mark right here. I go away like an inch or so, I mark. 3/8 of an inch, I mark. 3/8 of an inch and mark all around my pattern piece. This is it. It will take a little bit of time. It's a bit maybe old school, you will say, but this saves me, you know, a lot of issues when I'm turning my pattern pieces, or even when I'm sewing, because to sew a bulky seam, you really have, you have to use your home jumper, or you know, if it's a very delicate fabric like the vinyl, you run the risk of really scratching it and you know, ruining your project. So I'll just match those lines like so. Et voilà. Now I can take out those parts that I've traced. I take out just like this. I cut it away. And I'm sure that I'm taking out the three eighths of an inch that I don't need on this pattern piece. And then I'll go and fuse it to my fabric. See, I've taken out the 3/8 of an inch that I don't need. I'm going to fuse it to my fabric like so, making sure that I have 3/8 of an inch on either side. This is what I'm going to do. So I come here also on the 3/8 of an inch side of the ruler. I will trace. I don't have to trace much. I have on the top, I know that it's 3/8 of an inch. Maybe on this side I trace 3/8 of an inch up to a certain point. I come here, I follow this line. It makes it very easy. This ruler makes it very easy to trace on all sides, on all types of pattern pieces. So right now I've traced only those two parts, and I know that if this corner is correct and this corner is correct, I have my 3/8 of an inch all around my pattern piece. And then I'll just go to my heat press or my seam press, and I fuse it to have a piece like this one. So it becomes, it is smoothly done, and I'll use the lining, and I'll put right side together and sew the lining, and then when I turn, it'll be very easy for me to turn and to top stitch, because this bulk, this interfacing, the deco bond in this case, will be out of my seams. Okay, so there you have it, how I take out, you know, some bulk out of my seam allowances using my 5-in-1 seam glide or the seam allowance ruler. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye bye.